Okay, so the next thing I'd like to do is spend a few minutes talking about how WordPress can be used. Initially, WordPress was a blog software. And so at its roots, you'll see a lot of blogging features. And so that was its initial function and use. What happened was somebody figured out that it was a very stable platform that could be used for page design. And so WordPress's initial function was subverted for web design. So first of all, let's talk a little bit about the idea of a content management system, CMS. And the idea is that when you have certain environments, there's different ways to build websites. One is using HTML and cascading style sheets and languages like PHP. So that's hard coding, and takes a lot of practice, and you have to have a certain type of mindset for that. You have to like coding, and you have to be relatively skilled at it. And so there's always been a need for tools that allowed people to build where they didn't have to go in and work directly with the code. Remember that the further your hands are away from the code, the less control you have directly over what's happening. So it's a trade-off between ease and functionality and use and having direct access to the code. So you have to make that kind of a split. So when WordPress was another example of this. So WordPress is a CMS system, a content management system, which means that the delivery of WordPress is dynamic. There are lots of different ways to build websites. WordPress is one of many CMS content management systems. Others are like Joomla and so on that deliver the same type of development. WordPress is a very popular page builder. About 40% of the world's websites exist on WordPress. WordPress is a free application, which is good, is that the use of WordPress in of itself is free. And then when you install WordPress, you will also always need to run at least one theme. One theme is present, and as many plugins as you think are necessary to give the site the functionality you need. And we'll go into what those different functionalities happen to be. So what is a CMS system? It's a dynamic way to build a website. When you have a CMS system, in addition to the website, in the background, there is a database. And that database allows for dynamic builds. In other words, the website is live on a server, and I can update it immediately and live. In addition to that, it comes with certain features that allow me to control various elements that I would have to write scripts for, like collecting information from the users. If I want to have a form, if I want to have a survey, if I want to have a shopping cart, it's already set up for those. I still have to build the form, build the shopping cart, build the features into it, but it's set up to readily accept those types of elements. So that is what WordPress can do, and that's why it's used. Now, there's different ways to use WordPress. Let's look at some of the different ways to use WordPress. One is that you have WordPress.org. So WordPress.org is the place you'll go when you have questions about how to build WordPress as a website, to use WordPress as a website. This is the hub for this. And here you can look at things like themes, you can evaluate plugins, you can get support and help, and so on and so forth. So the idea is that I can download a local version of WordPress from here. Now, the WordPress doesn't work without being on a server. That's why we're using local. But the idea is that when I have questions that I want answered about running local WordPress as a web builder, I go to WordPress.org. Okay. In addition to WordPress.org, there's WordPress.com. So the idea with WordPress.com is that this is a the location for a for WordPress as a blogging software. Okay, here we go. We want WordPress.com. Here we go. And the idea is that that you can get a free account at WordPress.com and use it up here. Now, the reason why we're not going to use WordPress.com is because if you set up a free account at WordPress.com, you're using it as a blogging software. And a lot of the features that we want to take advantage of in WordPress aren't available if you use it as a blogging software. Now, recently, WordPress, like in the last 5 years or ago, WordPress.com has made it where you can actually use WordPress.com for blogging and for web design. And you can set up an account here and you can pay to have a website at WordPress.com. But I don't want us to use that feature because it costs money, first of all, and the hosting is through WordPress.com. And the thing about WordPress is you set it up, it can be set up independently on any server. So that means that you're capable of using WordPress the WordPress as a web building software and uploading it to any host. You don't have to use WordPress.com as your host, and it's relatively expensive. So WordPress.com, initially its focus was on blogging. Now it's blogging and web hosting, and you can set up hosting here and set up a website here, but that's not the way we're going to go. But what we want to work on in this class is using WordPress as a page builder. Okay, you can set up WordPress as a web page builder here, but you're locked into working from WordPress.com and you're locked into their payment plans and so on. So what's the difference? What's the difference between a blog and a website? So that's an important question. So the first thing is a blog has posts instead of pages, and those posts are updated and the newest posts are shown first. A website has static pages. So that's one of the major differences there. The difference is that the blog software doesn't allow for the full functionality that the WordPress uses as a page builder does. So when I use the blog software, I'm severely restricted in my use of themes, and I'm restricted with the use of plugins. When I use WordPress as a page builder, independent of WordPress.com, then I have access to more high-end themes, and I also have an incredible amount of functionality when it comes to flexibility, when it comes to use of plugins, okay? And that is the major difference between WordPress as a blog software or WordPress as a web page building software. So when I use WordPress as a web page building software, I can go anywhere, set up a domain, set up hosting, install WordPress on at the web host's server and build my website and have a fully functioning website. Now I can have a WordPress website with blog elements or blog features, but they're two different things. Okay, so this is the WordPress.org, and this is where you will go for any kind of questions or to evaluate plugins and so on. And this is WordPress.com, and this is primarily a blog software, and now they've opened it up to also being a web design or web page builder as well. The third way to use WordPress is there's a third function called multi-user. Which we're not going to worry about. But the idea is, if I wanted to create something like a Facebook type of interface, I could use WordPress for those functions. So the idea here was just to give you an overview on the different ways that WordPress can be used.